Welcome to Scheduling Reports with OneDrive and Sage Intacct. So I'm going to show you how to set up the cloud storage target. We're going to show you how to schedule the report to go to someone's OneDrive folder. Okay. So it'd be useful, for example, maybe you want certain month-end reports to be scheduled to just go to your OneDrive folder automatically on a set day each month, or maybe some reports for project managers to go to their OneDrives. So that would be a good purpose for doing something like this. So first, you're going to set up the cloud storage. So you're going to go to Reports, Setup, Cloud Storage. You're going to hit Add. And here's the different storage types that you can choose from. So I'm going to pick OneDrive for this example. Also, on the help on this page, it is going to give you a help article on this specific page for cloud storage for setting up those targets. Okay, so you can see the different targets right there. And I usually just put like the user's name, the employee's name. I'm going to pick them here. Put their email address in. So this would be for error results. And then if you want, any Sage Intacct user can choose to upload files to this person's OneDrive, then you'll want to make it public. So you want to uncheck the private there. Okay. And then active. And then you can hit save here. Okay. So the first time you're going to have a login button here. So you're going to hit login. This is going to establish the connection to your cloud storage account. Okay. Now I've already logged in previous sessions to this specific OneDrive and set up this target previously. So normally it's going to come up with your Microsoft sign on and you put your username and password. And you're going to need to accept a few screens, and then you should be able to grant permission for Intacct to access the cloud storage account. So you also might need to contact whoever's responsible for your specific cloud storage account if there needs to be something done inside of there in order for Intacct to have permission to be able to access that cloud storage account. So there might be something additional you'll need to do on top of that acceptance button that you'll get in order for it to work properly. So just a side note there. Okay, so once this is set up, then we're going to go over to the report center and we're going to schedule a report. So just a quick recap, all of your reports in report center in your different financial report area, your custom report area and your interactive custom report area are listed here. So make sure that you can use the search if you need to find one a little easier, and make sure you are on all applications. Sometimes that trips people up. So find your report, you're going to click on it and you're going to memorize it, and then you're going to schedule it. Okay, so I'm going to walk through a brand new scheduling here. So I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to schedule this WIP report that I have to go out to my OneDrive folder. So right here, I don't have like an edit schedule next to it, so I need to memorize it first. So we're going to click on it here. So I'm going to click on this bank register one here. So notice there's no edit schedule type of action next to it. So if it has nothing here to pick from, I need to memorize it first. So some of these have like a schedule already here, so you don't need to memorize that at that point. Okay. So if it's already been memorized or if it's a financial report, you don't necessarily need to memorize it first. But this one does not have that, so I need to memorize it first. So first I'm going to click on it. And I'm going to schedule this out to go out every month at the end of the month. So I want to see the current month bank register activity. So I'm going to leave it just like this. and I'm going to memorize it. And I like to memorize it and call it the same exact name so I know which report I memorized from. You can make it public. And now it's going to pull up this screen. I'm going to schedule it from right here. Okay, and I'm going to start the schedule at the end of this specific month, and it's going to go out every month, every 1 month, and you can choose to end it after a certain number of times, you know, if you want, or a specific end date. I'm going to come down here and pick store in cloud, and then I'm going to pick that target I set up, that Lisa OneDrive target. And I can even do something like this, and it makes the folder in my OneDrive. Name it maybe like bank register current month. And I save that. So every month at the end of the month, because it says the 31st, it's going to send this out at the end of the month. Okay, so that's how that works with the date there. I hit save. Okay, now that is scheduled. Okay. And now what happens at the end of the month in the OneDrive, you're going to have your month-end report folder that it will automatically create if it's not there already. And then if I open this up, you'll see the bank register file right here that it will store on 12/31. So basically, just a little quick side note, you can store Excel, you can store PDF printable types of files in OneDrive, or really when you schedule it to email as well. So if I go back up here and look at the scheduled bank register, refresh my screen there, then you can see at the bottom, you can pick Excel, PDF, text, HTML. So you can do different formats there. A lot of people like to do certain reports to Excel for these scheduled reports. Okay, so just a tidbit there. So that's how you schedule and set up your cloud storage for OneDrive and how you schedule those reports to your OneDrive folders.